NCCM Nhật Bản. Dr. Suzuki, please.
Thank you for attending this presentation. My name is Manabu Suzuki. I'm a doctor of respiratory medicine from NCCM in Japan. Thank you for inviting me at this beautiful congress in Vietnam. It's my pleasure to join this conference. Oh, so let's start for my lecture. At first, I'll introduce you about the connection between Vietnam and me. In September 2009, I worked in my old school hospital, 16-year-old female with no medical history, developed fever and general fatigue and diarrhea. She had visited to Japan from Vietnam to attend the international exchange event. A rapid diagnosis kit at a local clinic showed type A influenza. She was given 10 milligram Zanamil inhalation twice daily. The following day, her body temperature rose to over 40 degrees and she experienced respiratory distress. Therefore, she was transported to our hospital by ambulance. On arrival, her blood pressure was 19 and her heart rate 150 and desperate rate was 35. Oh. And she was admitted a large dose of crystalloid fluid and neophylline. And mechanical ventilation with endotracheal intubation was begun. And we performed much disciplinary treatments such as PMX and other tools. She was gradually improved to the general conditions. About a month later, she could come back home. And finally, we published in this case in ICM. This picture was taken by the patient family at that time. This one had begun to take oral intake because she was recovering from the state of respiratory failure. And next picture confirmed the situation to general ward just before leaving hospital, and it is in a state of becoming completely refreshed. After the patient discharged, we received a letter of the appreciation from the Vietnam embassy. After that, I moved to the President Hospital in 2013. Since then, I have worked continually. So I will introduce about our hospital. This hospital is one of the five national centers in our country and has 781 beds, and there are 43 departments at the general hospital. At the national center, many foreigners have visited to treat. Nowadays, I hear that about 10% of new patients are foreigners. And it existence in Shinjuku, Tokyo, and it's localized approximately 2.4 kilometers from Shinjuku Station. And there are nearby Kabukicho, there it's famous for the nightlife district. Therefore, many foreign patients visited to our hospital. And we have also a TB ward, and it's a medical institution designed designated for special infectious disease. In October 2013, Japan accepted the first suspected Ebola patient. The patient had received medical treatment in our hospital. This is pictures of that this many press reporters were visiting in front of hospital. Under the circumstance I'm working in at the Department of the Respiratory Medicine. So well, I would like to talk more deeply about the bronchial artery embolization as a treatment for hemosputum, including in history. First, it's important to know the target accurately. So what is the hemosputum and what is the cause? I will describe the general definition. Hemosputum is the coughing up of blood or blood disputum from the lung airway. And hemosputum can range from small quantity of blood disputum to life-threatening amount of blood in the absence of any accompanying sputum. Massive hemosputum defined as a 200 to 1,000 milliliters of blood coughing up within a period of 40 hours or less. And massive hemosputum requires a prompt response to ensure adequate ventilation, protect the airway, and control of hemosputum. Dependent on the amount of the hemosputum, it's classified into three categories. There are differences in some amount of dependent on the report, but in many cases shows the amount like a slight. This slide shows a strategy to treat for hemoptysis in our hospital. In my image, three categories will be like this image. Massive sputum seems very severe. And then, what causes such hemosputum? There are a variety of underlying diseases in the background, such as a cryptogenic or primary parenchymal region and associated with cardiovascular region and others. So when a patient presents with massive hemosputum, what should we do the initial treatment? According to the common textbook as follows, to correct positioning to the patient and establish the patient airway and ensure adequate gas exchange and cardiovascular function, and control the bleeding. I showed you the, some hemostatic agent. When slightly bleeding stature can be enough to oral intake medicine like this, but massive hemosputum should administrate these drugs intravenous. These drugs are very important to treat for hemosputum. If we encounter more severe patients in the emergency room, we need to more advanced treatment. Since we can make use bronchoscopy, because this tool is used by usual clinical practice. If we must do not more advanced intervention, we can perform hemolung intubation or insert bronchial blocker into the bleeding site to protect healthy lung site. It is important strategy to maintain oxygenation. This slide shows three companies blocker. We usually choose these tools, and these insert the broncho blocker into the bleeding side to protect the healthy lung, like this, and by the way, how in my maze, a lot of respiratory medicine doctors probably do not prefer to examine these patients too much. I think many doctors feel helpless in the situation because they cannot do anything other than hemostatic agent. After this treatment, we will give the patient vitality, and we only wait to pray to God. And this is Japanese style. If our prayer will come true, we will be happy. But unfortunately, when we cannot control these hemoptysis, we must do more advanced interventions such as BAE or surgical. So regarding surgical treatment, we rely on the thoracic surgeon. Therefore, we also feel powerless in such situation. Surgery is an effective modality to control hemoptysis in patients with localized disease, but it is unknown to especially high mortality to treatment emergency surgical treatment. This patient undergo surgical treatment has reported mortality rate between 2 and 18%, which may be a marker of severe of underlying disease. When the patient receives so many, when the patient received emergency surgical therapy due to more severe or worse condition, the mortality is reached over 50. On the other side, when the patient who needs to surgical therapy received the conservative treatment, the mortality rate lies 78%. And however, most of these series were reported several decades ago. Data from China and other countries suggested somewhere lower mortality and mortality rates. So therefore, we had required a way to minimally invasive and more reliable intravascular treatment. Here I introduce the history of BH and BAE. In 1964, Dr. Biamonte et al. Reported about guided catheterization of bronchial arteries. He reported 100 cases of selective catheterization of bronchial artery in human. In this report, 55 cases were cultured normal of lung. they showed that the orifices of bronchial artery are thought usually at or slightly above the level of the left main stem bronchus between the upper border of TH5 and the lower border of TH6. It also describes the technique of aspects such as how to cannulation left and right bronchial artery by using the selective catheter and how to increase the contrast medium and so on. And according to Lebo, 82.8% of bronchial artery were originated in this area, and other reported 70.1% according to Cordell. And this is Japanese data. According to our country data, Dr. Ishihara was reported at chest in 1974. To investigate the association between selective bronchial arteriography examination and hemoptysis in 122 patients with began pulmonary disease such as pulmonary tuberculosis and bronchiectasis. In the Mercury hypervascular group, the patients who had blood in sputum were significantly larger in number than those of moderate or mild group. The different in frequency of blood sputum or hemoptysis between these two groups with and without the bronchopulmonary anastomosis was statistically significant. So in actually BAE situation, in addition to image finding of CT according angiography based on these angiography findings collected with hemoptysis, and we detected two hemoptysis related artery. This same I introduced to review the bronchial artery anatomy. In 2002, Yan and etc. all reported in radiographics the variety of bronchial artery shows almost of common pattern. About 20 of bronchial artery do not rise from descending thoracic aorta. It is said other it is said that other anomalous origin come from the subclavian artery or internal mammary artery or bronchocephalic trunks and so on. So pay attention to treatment for embolization. In 1977, Dr. Remy in France reported the data using gelatin sponsor. This is the first report in case series to be performed the BAE for treatment with gelatin sponsor. 104 patient present with either massive or repeated hemoptysis were treated by embolization of the bronchial artery with dissolved material as a gelatin sponge. The procedure was performed via selective catheterization of the abnormal arteries. And 41 patients Of the 49 patients treated during hemoptysis, immediately arrest of bleeding was affected in 41. But six of these patients suffered relapse and two to seven months after the procedure. On the other hand, this is the Japanese data. Dr. Hayakawa reported the efficacy of PA using the same gelatin sponsor in 1992. This study was to evaluate the immediate and long-term result in 63 patients who underwent transarterial embolization for control of hemoptysis. This study reported that overall immediate success rate was 86.1 and after the long-term follow-up, 1 year after was 72.2% and 2 years after was about 60%. The mainly under disease shows 32 cases of chronic inflammatory disease. And then in about 10 years, VA treatment used the gelatin sponsor has been widely spread around the world. This effort shows that to compare the effectiveness of and safety of super-selective bronchial artery embolization is that of non-super-selective embolization in control of hemoptysis. Retrospective case analysis was done of 47 patients with hemoptysis originated from the variety of cause. And in 22 patients, embolization was performed super selective using microcatheter inserts into the bronchial artery beyond the spinal or mediastinal branches. And in the remain of 25 patient embolization were performed at operating the bronchial artery with five French catheter. And all causes use gelatin sponge and a combination of metallic coil in super selective group was 36 and non-super selective group was 12%. The results show right side table. Initial hemoptysis control rate was 96%. In the super selective, and the selective group was 88%. This slide shows cumulative hemoptysis control rate of the super selective and the non-super selective groups were showed in this slide. Of the complication occurred in the non-super selective group. This study concluded that the super selective embolization is safer and more effective way to control hemoptysis than the non-selective method. When we performed the BAE spinal When we perform the VA, spinal infarction is the most major complication. Now explain the anterior spinal artery syndrome differ from Wikipedia. This is anterior spinal artery. So, as you showed, this is an important thing. It's characterized by a loss of motor function below the level of injury, and the loss of sentence and sensation carried by the anterior columns of the spinal cord, and the preservation of the sensation carried by the posterior columns. Anterior spinal artery syndrome is the most common from the spinal cord infarction. At the point of the avoided complication, it is necessary to insert the microcatheter as possible as until the peripheral area. At that point, initially to start the VA treatment, it must be necessary to have such a great skill to perform the safe and effective embolization. So therefore, only few patients such in IVR doctor who had such a great skill were performed VA. The first performed VAG to present the error is dramatically changed. Technological evolution has been remarkable, and our life has become dramatically for these skills. To spend for the era, the influence did to technological evolution give also remarkable effect in medical world. Regard to the evolution of VA, there is a three main categories. First, it showed a evolution of device and CT angiography and the development of the much embolization materials. So now a lot of catheterization can be used, and coaxial microcatheter system can be established like this. And this slide has, and number second is CT angiography is the most useful tool, as you showed. And this slide shows the development of multiple embolization material using a metallic coil. These technology development lead us to VAE can perform our respiratory medicine. So, sorry. Conclusion. I'm sorry. So, in my take-home message. Finally, let's make a BA team in respiratory medicine in Vietnam. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Suzuki, for the nice presentations about interventions in hemoptysis. So now we should have some minutes for the discussion. First of all, I have two questions to Dr. Suzuki. The first question, for diagnosis, do you usually do the CTAs for finding the cause of hemoptysis? And the second question, and how do you select the material for embolization of hemoptysis? And then, all of you should have a question. Tức là mời các anh chị, chắc là ta dành độ 5-10 phút để cho cái thảo luận. Thì tôi có hai cái câu hỏi cho ông Suzuki. Câu hỏi thứ nhất, tức là ở bên Nhật, ông có hay...